Accept council men and women whose problems are so great it's almost impossible for them to find help anywhere else. People, for example, like May.
Before I came, I thought my life was pretty normal and I drank heavily. When I came here, I stopped and I found that I drank, alcoholically. My life was in a terrible mess. Through coming here, which has been 6 weeks, but it's been tremendous to me.
Accept has helped over 25,000 other drug, drink and tranquilizer addicts over the 15 years it's been in existence, but it's now threatened with closure. They need £564,000 to continue operating for the next 2 years. Their biggest source of income, regional and district health authorities, are strapped for cash. Local authorities and private sponsors can't make up the difference. Accept believes the government should now help.
But we actually save government a great deal of money. We only, for each client that comes here, it costs round about £250 to help each client. If they go into a health authority service, it's somewhere around £900 a week. A liver transplant costs around £30,000 for each person. I think we're providing a good deal.
That's why today they've been lobbying MPs to support their case, particularly those in whose constituencies Accept works.
The government and the health authority are both very concerned that Accept should continue as well. The problem is that neither one will accept responsibility for funding it. And it's really my job is to make sure that somebody in either of those two organisations says, yes, this is my responsibility. And I think that from that point of view, this is something which is well achievable.
Accept's needs are urgent, though. Their money and the lease on their head office in Fulham run out in 3 months' time. If they can't get more cash and alternative premises, they'll simply close down on March the 31st. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.